Okay, video number three, but maybe this is more serious. I will share with you two stories, and I'll give you an introduction first. One of the stories I'm familiar with because I was around when it was happening. The second one is more of, I heard about it, but I don't know, I cannot confirm it for sure, but it's a good story anyway. We've learned in schools and from our parents and people around us sometimes that, look, you know, you should work on your weakness and in order to improve in life, whether it's school or anything else. Now, we also learn in strategic planning, strategic management, that organizations should do SWOT analysis, which is, I'm sure most of you know what SWOT is, but it's basically, it's not the SWOT people with weapon, it's SWOT with SWOT, which is strengths, weakness, which is about you and your ability as an organization usually, and opportunities and threat that typically come from outside. So one of the first steps for strategic planning is to think about SWOT analysis, to perform a SWOT analysis, to understand really where you are in terms of strengths and weakness and what the opportunities and threats you face. So with that in mind, as individual, we can do the same. And going back to what I said at the start, is basically we learn as we should work on our weaknesses in order to improve. Well, the two stories, one of them maybe will support that concept, and the other one will debunk it. When I was going to school at the University of Houston back in the early 80s, a big guy came from Nigeria who used to play football, not the American one, the international one. And his name was Hakeem Olajuwon. He came to the University of Houston, but because he was a big guy, his body was made to be a center for basketball, but he never played basketball. Anyway, he got into the team at the University of Houston, recruited him, and he started to play. And obviously, many of you probably heard of Hakeem. He was a great player, and he became one of the best players, and I think he's in the Hall of Fame in the U.S. now. Hakeem had a weakness, is basically whenever their team playing and towards the end, if the two teams are very close and everybody knows if Hakeem goes to the basket, he will score. So they discovered, usually the enemies, the other teams, that Hakeem is not very good at free throws. So what do? Is Hakeem running to the basket, they know he's going to score. So they fouled him. And if they fouled him, what happened? He'll have to shoot two balls. And his score was average about 50% or less. So basically, or 52%, I can't remember, it's been almost more than 30 years. However, they know if they fouled him, at best he will get one ball in. Which means in a close game, there is a chance that the University of Houston team would lose. And Hakeem had to work hard, and I think University of Houston came to the championship once or twice, but I can't remember if they ever won it. When he graduated, he went to the Houston Rockets. Now, being a team of basketball, this weakness that Hakeem has, we know his strength, but this weakness is usually often enough cause the team to lose. So he had to improve his scoring. Now, I'm not into basketball or statistics, but if I recall, he was able to elevate his scoring of the free throws from about 50% or so to more than 80%. Which means what? Which means in a close game, if he's going to the basket, he might score or he might not, but if they fouled him, there is a very good chance he will score both points. So fouling him was not a factor anymore. And as a result of that, that weakness, that was killer weakness, he had to improve on it in order to save the team. Great. What to do? What's the next story? The next story is, this which I don't know for sure, but I've heard it through the grapevines, is Tiger Woods. Obviously, many remember him as one of the best golf players. Again, I'm not into golf. I don't know much about golf, but I know enough about the story. And the story says that Tiger had a weakness. He was not very good at shots when the ball fell into the sand trap. So basically, this is a weakness. What we learn in school, we need to work on improving the weakness in order to become better at what we do. However, my understanding is that Tiger Woods decided to work on his strengths, which is don't get the ball in the sand trap. If he can do that, if he can avoid getting the ball in the sand traps, he wins. So that's a weakness. But instead of trying to improve on a weakness, he chose to work on his strengths. And that, at least again, what I've heard about this story. True or not, it makes a good story, doesn't it? Good night.